The Sony Spider-Man universe began with Tom Hardy's Venom in 2018, directed by Ruben Fleischer, and 3 years later, Venom: Let There Be Carnage, directed by Andy Serkis, was released. While neither of the films were masterpieces, people found them to be okay films, but they were missing something. They were missing Spider-Man. And with Tom Hardy teasing a Spidey appearance in Venom 3, I want to pitch my version of the film. So, here's my pitch for Venom: Along Came a Spider. Inside a police car, Yuri Watanabe, played by Karen Fukuhara, is driving and Eddie Brock is in the driver's seat. After the deaths of Carnage and Shriek, Eddie and Venom are known fugitives, and have been on the run for a year, but they've finally been caught. They arrive at Ravencroft Institute, and they are taken to their cell. Eddie yells at Venom, saying that if Venom didn't eat Cletus' head, they wouldn't be in trouble.
Eat this guy!
But Venom argues back, saying that Cletus would have gone on the run again if he stayed alive. Eddie says that Cletus would have been sentenced to death anyways. Venom sighs. Meanwhile, thugs are robbing a bank. Suddenly, they are webbed up, and Spider-Man, played by Andrew Garfield, reveals himself from the shadows, and throws some quips at the baddies. The police arrive and take them away. After the MCU, Peter Parker asked Doctor Strange to cast a spell to make everyone forget Peter Parker is Spider-Man. It revived and displaced the Raimiverse Eddie Brock, played by Topher Grace, putting him in the SSU, with his symbiote. He doesn't know he's switched universes, however, and he still wants to get revenge on Peter Parker. He calls the police to report a quote-unquote crime and locks some police officers in a store. He uses their computer to try finding Peter Parker, which is successful. In Ravencroft, Eddie bumps into Harry Osborn, played by Dane DeHaan, and Eddie asks how Harry got into Ravencroft, and Harry explains how he killed Spider-Man's girlfriend, Gwen Stacy.
No, don't pull! No!
Ah! And had to be apprehended. Eddie asks how he knows Spider-Man, and Harry says he's an old friend. Eddie nods and walks off. Peter Parker enters his house. He still lives with Aunt May, played again by Sally Field, and they have a friendly conversation. Peter walks to his room and looks at his calendar. It's almost Aunt May's birthday and he still doesn't have enough money to buy a gift. Peter puts on his Spidey mask, but suddenly a tendril pulls him out of the building and onto another apartment building. Peter and Raimi Eddie face off, until Venom removes Peter's mask to reveal his face. Malice wipes off Eddie's face, and is replaced with confusion. You are not Peter Parker. Eddie says. Yeah? Yeah, I am. Unexpectedly, the symbiote leaves Eddie and goes to Peter. Peter quickly puts on his mask and swings off. Eddie screams in anger. Anne Weying, played by Michelle Williams, visits SSU Eddie in his cell. Anne asks how he ended up in prison, and Eddie explains the whole story. Anne tells Eddie that she'll try breaking him out, and she just needs to think of a plan. Eddie nods and Anne leaves. Peter is swinging through New York City. He likes the way the suit feels, but he is unaware of what is coming next. Patrick Mulligan, played by Stephen Graham, is in hospital. He has been infected by an offspring of the Carnage symbiote, causing him to have glowing blue eyes. Suddenly, the symbiote consumes him and he roars, brutally murdering all the hospital staff. He breaks out and goes on a rampage as Toxin. Dr. Dan Lewis, played again by Reed Scott, is testing on a piece of the Venom symbiote he got his hands on. He has been diagnosed with cancer and doesn't have long left to live. He tests an anti-serum on the symbiote and it turns white. Peter is walking down the street. He looks up to see an advertisement on a billboard. J. Jonah Jameson, played by J.K. Simmons, is there, saying that whoever can capture the best footage of Spider-Man earns a $1,000 check and a spot at the Daily Bugle. Peter then runs back home to put on his symbiote and takes a video of himself. He submits it to the Daily Bugle website. SSU Eddie is in the dinner hall. exercising. The venom symbiote crawls up to a security guard's head and quickly eats it, drawing the attention of everyone there. Eddie then sneaks out with Venom and gets in Ann Wayne's getaway vehicle, and rides them to Dan Lewis's lab. Toxin encounters Rhymey Venom, and they make a deal. He helps Venom kill Spider-Man, and he'll help Toxin go on a rampage. Toxin agrees, and they go to kill Spider-Man together. Dan explains his cancer diagnosis, which worries Ann and Eddie, but amuses Venom. Suddenly, the white symbiote engulfs Dan and he becomes Anti-Venom. Anti-Venom, feeling much more powerful and thinking he can do good, jumps out the lab window and goes to thwart a bank robbery. Dan goes to stop the Rhino, played again by Paul Giamatti, from robbing a bank. He apprehends Rhino and has him arrested, which makes Dan feel good. Peter catches Anti-Venom swinging through the street, and violently beats him up before taking a picture of him, and swinging off. Dan feels weaker than ever and limps back to his lab. At another bank, Spider-Man has just arrived. He sends a terrifying glare towards the crooks, before brutally beating up all of them, and he kicks one of them out of the bank. But he recognizes one of the faces. It's Uncle Ben's killer. Spider-Man starts crying, and takes him up to the roof of the bank. He throws the killer off and kills him. Just then, flashbacks flood his head, of Uncle Ben telling him the responsibility line. He wonders what he has done, and swings to the nearby clock tower, the same one where he lost Gwen. He triumphantly rips off the symbiote, and the true Spider-Man returns. Toxin and Rhymey Venom find Spider-Man, swinging around while holding the symbiote in a jar. Toxin pounces on Spidey and breaks the jar, allowing Eddie to regain the symbiote. Toxin is suddenly punched, and most of the symbiote leaves him, and fuses with Eddie's Venom symbiote, creating Toxi-Venom, and he runs away. Spidey picks Patrick up, and Patrick promises to help Spider-Man from now on. A piece of the toxin symbiote taps Patrick's shoe. Patrick looks at it, then looks back up at Peter. Peter nods before looking at Toxi-Venom heading to Aunt May's house. Peter and Patrick head towards him. Toxi-Venom arrives at Aunt May's house. Spidey and Toxin arrive right after. Spidey sends an intense stare to Eddie. He tries to bargain with Eddie, but he won't budge, and Eddie uses a tendril to choke Aunt May. Spidey punches Eddie in the nose, and the fight begins. Aunt May runs for her life. SSU Venom, Anti-Venom and Ann Wayne show up, and join the battle. SSU Eddie gives Ann a piece of the symbiote, and she turns into She-Venom. During the fight, Toxi-Venom stabs Anti-Venom's chest. He takes the Anti-Venom symbiote to become even more powerful. Spidey swings to the top of the building with SSU Venom, and Toxi-Venom follows. Toxi-Venom punches Peter again and again, before SSU Venom pounces on Toxi-Venom and they all fall through the building. The house is now rubble, and they all barely emerge alive. Dan doesn't have the same luck though, and he dies in Ann's arms. A few days later, SSU Eddie approaches Ann, who is in mourning, and is about to talk to her, when he decides to walk away. Venom asks why he didn't talk to Ann, and Eddie says that he doesn't want to talk to Ann while she's grieving her love, and how he can never have her back. It's Aunt May's birthday, and Peter has blindfolded May and taken her to a brand new apartment that he bought with his money from the Bugle after their house was destroyed. May hugs Peter and thanks him for doing this, and Peter then leaves to arrive at the Bugle, as his boss is waiting for him. Peter walks through the Bugle doors to meet Jay. Jonah Jameson, Robbie Robertson, played by Jimin Hounsou, and Mary Jane Watson, played by Shailene Woodley. Peter smiles, ready for a new chapter of his life. After being arrested for a few days, Rhymey Eddie is taken by Peter and SSU Eddie to Madame Web, played by Dakota Johnson, and she opens a portal to send Rhymey Eddie back home. The portal is opened, but they are all suddenly sucked in, and they land on Battleworld, setting them all up for secret wars.